Hi everyone, in today's session, I'd like to talk more about custom report templates, aka personalization of DPA, specifically about a data source named NoDetailed, and going into a use case of listing virtual machines without having VMware data collection in DPA. So one unique data source in DPA is called Node Details. You'll find it in the internal category. Every object in DPA is a node. Example, a backup client node, a group node, etc. And each node has a type designation. In the case of networker and vProxy backups, the virtual machine hosts are not networker resource IDs. The backups are created dynamically from VMware when it runs. This means that the VM hosts are not easily listed queried from networker, example by using NSRadmin. Reminder that DPA uses official APIs and CLIs and does not integrate with NMC. When DPA collects job data from networker, using job query MMInfo, and sees that there is a backup client that isn't known to DPA yet, it will then create a networker backup client node within DPA. This typically happens with vProxy backups. Thus, for DPA to know about it, at least one backup of the VM host must have been completed. So if you run a client details, aka the client configuration report on a networker server, you'll only see those listed that have resource IDs that are registered and defined and configured to networker. But if you expand the networker node in the scope and expand the backup client group, you may see other hosts, other backup clients that are not listed in the client configuration report. These are typically the vProxy hosts, because DPA detected there was a backup associated with this client for this networker server and thus created the networker backup client node object in DPA and slotted it in the list. This way, when you run standard reports on networker, the networker node, it will work, right? Even across virtual machines. So now with all that in mind, how do we get a list of vProxy hosts only? That is only the VM host clients, so that we can report on only those VMs as a contrived example, right? We would then do a diff of the list of node details with client config, right? Because client config contains all those with resource IDs, node details contains every single object. So if we diff the two, we should be able to find which ones are just the virtual machines. And we can take it a step further and create a smart group based on that report. So let's see what that looks like. So if I create a custom report template, add data source, it's actually called node details from the internal category, select it, drop it to the end of the flow, end of the report. You can see there are parameters, there are fields that you need that are displayed or returned. I'll leave it as default. I'll select on the entire configuration scope. And there you have it, right? You can see the node itself, and you can see the node is constructed by the server name, colon, the object type, colon, then the actual node name. There's also a subname associated with it, and then the actual object slash node type. So you can see in this particular case, there's Evermore backup domain, Evermore backup client. If you scroll further down, there's networker backup pool, networker protection policy. So you can see every single object that can exist in the scope has a node type designation, right? And so in this particular case, we'd be interested in networker backup client, right? So let's advance this report a little bit. Title. So now this data source lists all the nodes for us, right? Now, how do we isolate it, or how do we filter it down to just the networker backup client node types, right? If you can see from the parameters here, there isn't a conditions filter. So how do we work around that, right? So I'm going to detach to the end. And what you do in DPA is we use an operator called dummy, right? Dummy does absolutely nothing to the data itself, but it gives you the capability to filter, gives you the capability to add a condition to this. So for example, the type equal to networker backup client. Okay. I take that to the end, look at the fields, always remember to include your subfields. Validation status is good. Let's preview this. And there you can see we've just filtered it down to just networker backup client node types. Okay. So let's take it the next step further, right? We want to now find just the list of virtual machines. So we know that the data source listing those known configured clients to networker is in backup client config. So we'll bring that in, right? Now, in order to diff the two, in other words, to find the difference between the two, we are going to merge it. Now, for a merge to happen, you need to have common key fields. So let's just go to the merge operator quickly. If you look at the operator description, you'll see the rules of how the merge works and an example as well, if you're unsure. Right? Now the merge merges on common key fields. That's a very important item to remember. So I'm going to select the merge, but before I do that, let's have a look at the client config fields. I don't actually need all these fields, so to make it more efficient, I'm going to deselect it. All I really need is the server name and the client name in this particular purpose, right? The rest, there are other key fields, so they remain checked slash ticked, which is also fine. Now, if I look on the node details side, I don't have a client name, right? So how do we get it to merge? So first let's decide which field it needs to merge with. It's not type and it's not node, because remember, node has the server name, colon, the type, colon, and the object name. So it's actually subname that we want to merge it with, right? Now to change the name of the field, we can do one of two things. We can add an operator called rename field, or we could just change its label, right? But we need to set it as a key as well. So what I'm going to do here is make sure that is included. So now you can see client, that in the next step in the flow after node details, we've given that subname field a new name, a new label, and called it client. So at the dummy stage, it sees it as client, right? Now, to merge two data sources together, you need key fields. None of these are key fields, right? You can expand it to check. There's not a key, not a key, not a key. I could visually see because none of them are bothered. So, to make one of them a key, there's a set key operator. Okay. I'm going to bring that in. I'm going to add the dummy to it. And in the set key, in the parameters, I want the client field to be set as a key. So if I go to fields now, include the fields, and you can see client is in bold. And if I expand that, you'll see that it's set as a key. Now we can merge. So we're going to drop backup client config onto the merge, and we're going to drop the set key onto the merge. Right, so if we look at the merge itself, you'll see, let's include all the fields. There's only one client name, and it's brought in the node and the type from the new node details data source. Let's drop that to the end of the report flow. Validation all good. Let me do a save so I don't lose this. And let's do a preview. And let's limit my testing to exactly that one network or server. And there you can see it's merged on the client name, and there's the type and the node, right? And you can see those that have a network or server are registered known networker backup clients. And these ones at the bottom are the virtual machines. Okay, so to get just the list of virtual machines after this comparison, we'll just filter out those that don't have a server name. Right, how do we do that? So we go to the merge, we go to conditions, edit condition, where the server name is missing. Save. Let's preview this. There we go. Right. So you can see there's the type and there's the client names. Right. The server name no longer shows because it's all empty. As you know, in DPA, if a field is selected and available to show in the rendered report, but it's all empty, we won't show the field at all because it's a waste of space. Right? Obviously, there are ways and means to force it back in through report format if you wish. But let's continue with this example and not digress. So I'm going to save and close this. Now, as I said, how do we then use that report not only to list just the virtual machines, but to run standard reports on it? Let's go to group management. I will go and create a smart group. Remember, the configuration tree, configuration scope, is for DPA configuration purposes. So to create reporting groups, you should create another group and create them in there, right? And I'll just simply call these VMs. Define single smart group level, custom report, list of VMs. Right, there's no filter scope. I'm going to, for testing purposes, I'm just going to use network 02, our example, so that we stick to the premise. Time period, I'll just say now, because we want to know what the latest list of clients is, not what it was last week or the week before, right now when it runs. Now, the children type. We go back to the objects, the nodes. What kind of nodes do you want to create in the scope so that you can report on it? Right. If we choose backup client, you'll see there's two asterisk fields that you need. You actually need the server name field and the backup client field. But if you remember correctly, we don't have the server name anymore because it was blank. So how do we do this? We will then create them as host objects, right? So when it creates an object in this tree of type host, what name do you want DPA to slot into that object? And that would be the client name. Okay. So if we okay to this, generation frequency, I'll do on demand for now. And if I expand, those are the virtual machines that didn't show up in client details. Remember, these are the virtual machines. So the beauty of this is I can go to run reports. Let's refresh the config just to make sure it's included. There's the virtual machines. I can say VMs. Okay, so you can see that I've run a standard report card, I've run a standard job summary just on the list of virtual machines. So the couple of principles that I wanted to show you here is that the node details can be used to look at internal objects to DPA and use them to find just the virtual machines, but you could use it for other purposes as well. I also, in this example, wanted to show you how to use the merge operator, how to merge a data source, two data sources together on common key fields. And if I go back to the smart group, I limited the smart groups to just that one network or server, purely for testing purposes, right? Now that I've tested it and it works as I'd like it to, I can now go back into the smart group and change it so that it goes and works across all network servers, right? But this is because the report template filters for networker backup client node types, right? So it's only applicable to network. Right. Hope that helps. Thank you. Bye.